Do you know who Kurabal is? Most likely many of you answered no. I didn't know it either when I first read this name. But what if I tell you that almost all of you know who he, or rather she is? Would you believe me? Hello everyone, I'm Irene Ridarelli, writer, blogger and a passionate reader. And this is Into the Books. As I stated earlier, I'm sure you've heard about this mysterious person because he, or rather she, is the author of Villette, The Professor, Shirley, Emma, Jane Eyre. If you thought I was talking about Charlotte Brontë, yes, you're right. It happens that Kurabal is a pseudonym she used for a short period of time. In fact, Jane Eyre, the subject of today's episode, was published under Charlotte's real name. So, if you're ready to be blown away by the power of Charlotte Brontë's rebelliousness, sit back and enjoy today's episode. Jane Eyre is an orphan. When her parents die, her uncle Misery takes her into his home. But when he also dies, Jane is sent to an orphanage. The harsh living conditions in the orphanage further forged her character, and Jane soon learned not to complain about what happens to her and to react immediately to life's blows. While at Lowood, she receives the necessary training to become a governess. Because of her skills, she is called to Thornfield, the home of Mr. Rochester. Mr. Rochester is enigmatic, elusive, and impenetrable. This is what makes Jane fall in love with him. However, our young protagonist is well aware that she does not meet the necessary requirements to get him to notice her. But what she doesn't realize is that Mr. Rochester is already totally in love with her. The depth of her soul, her undeniable intelligence and incorruptibility of her spirit is what made him fall in love with her. His blind passion for Jane is so strong that the fear of losing her due to his dark past scares him so much that he decides to hasten his marriage to her before the truth comes to light. On their wedding day, Jane finds out what Edward Fairfax Rochester is hiding. And although she loves him with all her heart, she cannot ignore what she has just learned. So all she can do is run away from Thornfield. Shortly after Jane's departure, a fire ravages the house. But she doesn't find out what has happened until she returns. Although the girl has tried to repress her feelings for a long time, fate always finds a way to reunite what the soul demands. Jane Eyre is brave, strong, and independent. Jane's strength lies in her moments of introspection. Sometimes the practicality that characterizes her makes her seem cold, but in reality she's just a woman aware of herself and her resources, strengths and weaknesses. She knows she's not pretty, that she's helpless without her family to rely on and without money to support herself. But all of this doesn't stop her. Although this masterpiece was written in 1847, it is still current because it shows us how the problems faced by the protagonist in those times are not so different from ours. Charlotte Brontë takes us through each stage of Jane's growth, showing us how her strong and positive personality allows her to adapt to the circumstances she faces at each stage. 175 years later, this book is still that great work to be read, assimilated, and transmitted from generation to generation.